So, you're watching this because you like the idea of a degree that challenges and inspires your passion for research, provides you with flexibility in course choices, and allows you to be mentored by world-leading academics. Well, let's discuss a research-focused degree.
Great. So, what's the main difference between a research-focused undergraduate degree and a more traditional undergraduate degree?
Well, they are both undergrad degrees, but with a research-focused degree, you do additional work to gain early research skills.
How long does it take?
It's a unique four-year degree that is available as the PhB or Bachelor of Philosophy Honours, or a Research and Development degree, also known as R&D.
What makes ANU such a good place for undertaking a research degree?
ANU is a place of intensive research. We have first-class facilities to support the work of our researchers and students, from new laboratories to one of the largest university library collections in Australia, and are committed to providing the best possible environment for teaching, learning, and research.
So, what can I do with a research degree?
Many of our graduates continue pursuing their research interests in further study, but a research degree opens up a world of opportunities. Along with your academic skills, you'll also be armed with highly marketable skills in independent research, oral and written communication, and teamwork, making you an attractive prospect for potential employers.
So aside from gaining research skills, how exactly is a PhB degree different to other undergraduate degrees?
To start with, one quarter of the subjects you do in the first 3 years will be advanced studies courses designed just for you. So, you might take an advanced reading course with a world-leading scientist or historian, or join a working laboratory and contribute to cutting-edge research. For your fourth year, you'll undertake a major honours research project under the guidance of an academic supervisor.
Which colleges offer the PhB program?
Well, the PhB program is available in Arts and Social Sciences, Science, and Asia and the Pacific Studies. But in the ANU College of Engineering and Computer Science, the PhD programs are called R&D degrees and are only offered in engineering and advanced computing.
Well, I'm interested in a PhD, but does that mean I have to study philosophy?
No, not unless you want to. Each PhD program can be tailored according to your own research interests. So, as well as being able to choose from a variety of courses in your own academic college, you can also choose courses from other areas of the university.
Do I get to do classes with the other students?
Many of your classes will be with other students who are doing courses in the same subject area. But you'll also have opportunities to work independently or with your fellow PhB or R&D students, depending on how you've decided to structure your program that semester. And throughout the year, all PhB and R&D students will get together for activities such as barbecues, trips away to the ANU's coastal campus at Kiola, and conferences to present work to each other and to academics from across the university.
Sounds great, but is it a lot more work?
You'll do the same number of subjects each semester as other undergraduates, but the workload for the advanced studies or research project subjects you choose might be more than other undergraduate courses. For example, the length of the essays might be longer, or you might submit more pieces of assessment. But remember, you get to choose your own projects based on your own interests. So most students don't mind the extra workload because they're doing something they are truly passionate about.
Sounds great. How do I apply?
Well, to begin with, you'll need an ATAR score of 99. Some programs also require a written application, references, and an interview. For more information, visit the ANU website or join us at one of our advisory or open days and find out how you can embark on a journey of research and discovery.